NASA scrubbing its plan to launch Boeing's Starliner spacecraft today. You're seeing the aftermath live right now on your screens. Apparently, an automatic hold was triggered by the ground launch sequencer. That's the computer that launches the rocket. It stopped the countdown clock with 3 minutes and 50 seconds left to go. NASA says it is not clear what caused that automatic hold. Space and defense correspondent Kristen Fisher is live at the Kennedy Space Center for us. Also with us, we have Colonel Chris Hadfield, astronaut and retired commander of the International Space Station. Okay, so Kristen, what's the latest? What are you learning on the ground?
So right now, everybody is focused on the two astronauts on board this spacecraft, the commander, Butch Wilmore, and the pilot, Sonny Williams. Right now, you've got the blue team going in, and they've got to get these astronauts off safely. And they're essentially sitting on top of a bomb, right? A fully fueled rocket. This is highly flammable. It's dangerous work. And so right now, everybody is focused on getting these astronauts off. It's something they trained to do. They did this dozens and dozens of times during space shuttle launches, but it's still risky. So that's the primary focus right now. While they focus on that, engineers are going to be reviewing what triggered this automatic hold or an automatic abort by the computer that launches this rocket. That's the big question here. Was it any of these issues that they were troubleshooting earlier that perhaps led to this hold? We just don't know. What we're also trying to figure out now is, when could they try to launch again? As of now, they are going to prepare to try to launch tomorrow. That's the next backup date, a launch around noon. But it remains to be seen if they can fully recycle this rocket in time, because once you have a rocket that is fully fueled, it can take quite a bit of time to get it all the fuel out, and then you got to get it all the way fueled back up again. So that takes some time, but for now they're preparing for a launch tomorrow. Future backup dates are June 5th and 6th of next week. I know a lot of people are going to be thinking, wow, you know, Boeing had another issue, but this may not be an issue with Boeing at all. And here's why. This is an outdated model, so bear with me, just have to give you that caveat. But this is essentially what the rocket looks like on the launch pad, which is just about 4 or 5 miles behind me. On top is the Boeing Starliner spacecraft. That's what this crewed flight test is for. And this is where the two astronauts are sitting right now and where they're trying to get them out of. This is the body of the, this is the rocket. This whole long piece is the rocket. It's designed, built, operated by a totally different company, the United Launch Alliance. And so the issue with the first scrub on May 6th, that was an issue with a valve on this part of the rocket, not the Boeing Starliner spacecraft. And so that may be the issue again today. Perhaps this the computer that detected this issue might have noticed an issue on the rocket itself. We just don't know. It's just too soon to say. It's going to take some time for these engineers to kind of go over all the data and figure out where exactly that problem was. But Alisyn, just think, if you are Butch Wilmore or Sonny Williams, and you get all the way down to 3 minutes and 50 seconds before launch. For Sonny, she's been waiting, assigned to this mission for about 10 years. And you get that close and they say, oh, sorry, scrub. I mean, of course, first and foremost, you want to be safe, but just imagine all that adrenaline. And for Butch, the commander, he had just delivered this incredibly rousing speech. He'd said something to the effect of, let's fire this rocket. And then the hold, this automatic abort happened. So definitely disappointing for the astronauts on board, but you know, you'd rather be safe and alive than launch too soon before you're ready. So we remains to be seen what the issue is, Alisyn, and remains to be seen when they're going to try again.
Commander, what were your thoughts as you watched them get down to under 4 minutes and then it gets scrubbed?
Well, it's nothing new. I mean, that happened on the space shuttle, as Kristen mentioned, many, many times. That's why you have an automatic ground launch sequence or an automatic computer, because there are thousands of things that you have to check. to make sure the vehicle's healthy. And there's not enough people that could check them all fast enough. So you set up an automated system, and you go and check. And one of them, if it's out of family or if it got bad data, it says, hey, by our rules, we're not safe to launch today. We got to stop the launch count till we can figure out this problem. And I think it's not nearly what it seems for astronauts, the way that Kristen was describing it. Sonny and Butch have been training for years. The training is super realistic. And today, they got closer than they've ever gotten to launch. But it's just one more day of training. I had my launches delayed. The first space shuttle launch was delayed for years and years. So it's hard, you know, to launch a spaceship for the very first time with people on board. You want to get it right. And it'd be nice if we could have launched today, but it's far nicer to make sure that we know what the problems are and wait until we have a higher probability of success. So, disappointing, but one more day in the life of two astronauts.
Yes, we all agree that it is better to be safe on the ground. Do you think, Commander, that there's a chance that this can launch again tomorrow, or is that too soon of a turnaround?
Well, yeah, I mean, it sounds like the ground launch sequencer saw something that no one else had been tracking up until then. None of all, you know, all the flight controllers, all the people watching the data, they all thought, hey, everything looks okay. The computer saw something, and now we need to figure out exactly what it saw. And it might just be like a bad sensor, but, you know, you don't have time to troubleshoot it. Part of the problem is the world is turning and Florida comes underneath the orbit of the space station. And so the only time you can launch is when Florida is perfectly underneath the orbit. So as soon as the world turns a little more, you can't go today. Got to wait till the world turns once more. And maybe in the time that the world's going to turn here, 24 hours, all the smart folks will figure out, that was what the problem was, and give it another shot tomorrow or on the 5th or the 6th. You know, it's just how it goes. It would have been great to see them launch today. It'll be even greater to see them launch safely.
Commander, Kristen was just explaining to us how it's complicated to get the astronauts off the rocket now. You know, you don't just open the door and they hop out. There's a whole team that has to get them off. So what are they doing right now?
As Kristen mentioned, you know, if you were a kindergarten class drawing the picture of astronauts in a rocket ship, you could just sort of draw a bomb with seats on top. That's sort of what's you're on there. And so before you go and have the crew climb out, you want to make sure that all of that fuel, the solid fuel and the liquid fuels, the hydrogen, the oxygen, the kerosene, that there's no chance of a stray spark or ignition or procedure getting screwed up. So they want to check all those things. And you've got carefully written procedures to back out of a launch and safely extract the crew out. They climbed in when it was fully fueled, so it's not like there was a sudden change, but you just have to follow the procedures, and they're very methodical. There's no great hurry right now. The priority is to get the crew out safely. And the crew's like, great day of training. Sorry we disappointed everybody. Hopefully the weather's good tomorrow. We'll give it another shot.
Well, we'll be watching. Colonel Chris Hadfield, thank you very much for all the expertise. Kristen Fisher, thank you for all the reporting, as always. We really appreciate it.
Thanks, Alisyn.